very scary.
It's an honor, though.
Yeah. See, that's the difference between Irish and American. It's an honor. It's scary. there's your cultural gap.
I know.
But you know it is.
Because Americans are always like, ha, ha, ha. Like, it's, I mean, it's the best. It's like, man,
like, geez, girl, you can't do that. No, I can't do that. I have to go home. I'll have a cup of tea. But it was really scary and exciting. And we were very lucky because we didn't actually have to audition for the parts. They were offered to us, which is a joy in our business because it can be brutal. So that was really lovely. But it lends itself to a little bit more fear because you haven't even auditioned, you haven't even shown them what you do with the character in the audition room or during that process. So you're literally turning up on the day with your
first.
Well,
we got a little bit of preparation with the director.
We did with the director the day before. He took us all to breakfast. He was so great. I don't know what he did with you, but he sat down. He was an English fella, John Emile, and he said, and we're chatting away, chat, and he goes, "Darling, I'm very bored talking to you." I'm like, "Oh, sorry. Oh, I'm sorry." And he goes, "I want to talk to Corella." I'm like, "Oh God."
Oh yeah, no.
Did he do the same thing?
And
I'm sitting there like that, having breakfast with him. And next thing you know, it's like, "Oh, darling, someone bring me something decent to
eat."
It was so much fun just to sort of go in and get a sense for before you turned up on set. So.
Well, it gave you kind of a place to go and to leap off from and something to play. But
yeah.
I think before that, though, just being asked to do the part, you're like, okay, so what is it you see in me that makes you think octopus? You know, what is it you see in me that makes you think I should be a fat purple blonde octopus, you know, causing trouble?
Don't ask the questions you don't want to
answer. Right, exactly.
Ever,
so you're
ever,
just like,
ever.
All right, I just, no, you know, like, but, you know, the guys, you know, the boys had been fans of Alias, so they knew that I could, you know, play, you know, a dark and twisted character. And, the same thing with you. I know you were sort of feeling like, you know, what is it that's, you know.
I had one fan who said to me, "How do you feel about being cast as the ugliest Disney character of all time?" I'm like, "Oh, Jesus, fine. That's grand by me." It's
3 hours of makeup later, they had to make you look that way.
It was fun.
I know. I said I got called in.
But it is scary taking a role on after someone like Glenn Close has played it. You know, I couldn't go and watch her version of it. Even though I'd seen it years ago, I couldn't go and watch it because, no, too much fear.
Yeah, well, and
you have to bring your own take.
You've got to bring your own take. I tried to in the beginning sort of replicate the voice, like to sort of give me like the sort of gravitas, because my first scene was with Robert Carlyle in the aquarium.
That's
and
scary
it's like,
too.
You know, yeah, not like intimidating that I'm working with him and then doing this thing, and I was trying to, and they're like, "No, you know what? Just play it as is. Like, just play, you know, you are enough." And that was great to hear that you as, you know, Merrin, have what we need to bring to this thing. So just, and then also when you put on those costumes and the wigs and the, you know, the
and then you have to imagine
crown,
your tentacles.
I had to imagine tentacles and, you know, all these things. And you know, like, if you watch like the first episode we show, and like, I actually like kind of put up my arms, and they're like, "You don't put up your dukes. Your arms are there for you." And they put that in, you know. So, but to just know that what you bring to the table is enough and is what we're looking for. So that was
I brought my own bad breath. I brought that.
Every day, I'm telling you, she worked on that.